What's up, guys? Manny from Motor Million, and it's time to start putting our Penny Gallery V2 back together. Well, before I start putting this bike back together, I'm gonna take it further apart because I gotta change the windscreen. And if you guys have done a windscreen on a Penny Gallery V2 or V4, you gotta take almost everything apart, and everything is almost apart except this headlight fairing. That's gonna come apart. We're gonna install our clear WRS windscreen. If you guys are a fan of MotoGP or World Superbike, you guys will see giant WRS stickers. Almost more than half the field now uses WRS windscreens. And the guys who use it sometimes don't even say they're using it because they're not paid by WRS, but they make fantastic products and we've been a fan of them. There's smoke gray and clear colors. We're gonna go with the clear one just because this is more of a race-inspired build, even though it's a street bike. But I can't blame you guys who love that smoke gray color because it looks really, really good. And I think it'll probably look really good on this bike too, but we're going with the clear one. Speaking of the looks, we're actually gonna reveal the inspiration or the style of this bike. One's gonna go on the right side and the other one's gonna go on the left side. So let me get this on and then let me show you guys what we're thinking of, because we decided not to paint this bike, but we gotta do something special with it. So stay tuned for that. But first, let's install this beautiful windscreen. Well, our front headlight fairing is off and we have to remove it because of these two well nuts that are here. Because if you take these bolts off, these fall down below and then you'll never get them. That's why you gotta take apart the side fairings and the headlight fairing off a Penny Gallery V2, also on a Penny Gallery V4 as well. It's quite a bit of work actually just to change the windscreen, but the bike was already apart, so we're gonna do this now. And then once I put this back, I'll show you guys those pieces that I talked about to show you guys what our livery will look like on this Penny Gallery V2. Here's our stock windscreen. This is our WRS windscreen. There's not a huge difference, but if you put them side by side, you can see that the WRS windscreen is actually marginally taller. It also extends a little further back, and this will add that wind protection that you need when you're in full tuck. Obviously, if you are a track rider, this is almost a must. Other than being a taller windscreen, it actually is a little lighter because these are pretty thick. I think it's just because the regulations for having a windscreen for road use is completely different than having one that's for track use. At least I think they're not regulated in the US, but other parts of the world, like Germany, probably requires them to be this thick. One thing that I want to mention, what makes a good windscreen versus a bad windscreen, it's not about the height, obviously, but it's about the distortion that you have in your field of vision. And WRS has really, really been working on this since they are the technical suppliers of a lot of MotoGP and World Superbike teams, that they've really improved their manufacturing to make sure that there's little to none distortion when you're looking through the field of vision on your windscreen. That is actually something that's very important. Imagine you're in full tech, you're coming to a braking zone, you want to pick your marker. If there's distortion, you're not going to be able to pick your braking marker properly. So that's what makes a good windscreen. So distortion is very minimal on these WRS windscreens. I almost want to say that it's none. But with some models and the way that windscreens are, you might get just a little bit of distortion. But in the case of the ones with the Penny Gallery V2, there's almost no distortion at all. That's the windscreen done. It's a lot easier when your side panels are off. And once this windscreen is on the bike, now you could tell clearly that it's taller than the stock one. I don't have the exact measurements, but I think it's 15 millimeters taller. If I'm wrong, I apologize, but that's what I remember it being. It doesn't really say it on the box. But now it's time to reveal you guys what we came up with, because we really wanted to paint this bike to a livery which was white, red, and black, black being carbon. And then as we start putting everything together on this bike, we really fell in love with this matte gray or satin gray pieces, along with the gray touches that we did on the bike, or if you want to call them silver touches. And we started continuing along with it, and we decided that it would be a shame to get all this body panel off and then replace it with white painted livery. So we came up with this. Let me show you guys. So this is basically one of our side panels that goes onto the side over here. And as you see, this bike has gloss pieces that we've converted to carbon, like our front fender, and then it'll have matte pieces like this matte plastic, but also the matte finish of the bike. And I call it matte because it's probably satin. So when I say matte or satin, I'm pretty much talking about the same things. So this is what we came up with. If you can see, this is the stock plastic piece and this is the carbon piece. And we got Nicholas at Auto Laboratory to put satin PPF over the gloss carbon so that we could separate the parts, just like the stock one, where you see that it was gloss black, it is gloss carbon now, just like our front fender. And then this satin piece or the matte plastic piece that we have ended up being PPF'd over so that it looks now two-tone in terms of the finish on this carbon. I think it looks really cool. I'm gonna try to get this Italian flag sticker from the dealership so that we could at least stick it back on this piece so that we have a little bit of contrast. But this is it. Let me install both sides. So I'm gonna start with the right side and then I think we'll be done for this episode. I know it's a short and sweet one, but I really couldn't wait to show you guys these pieces, and our other pieces that we're waiting for are not done yet. I just want to put it on the bike, take a look, and I also wanted to see what you guys think of it. So let us know in the comments below if you really like this idea. We've already started along with it with our front fender, as I mentioned. And as we start putting the bike back together, it's really gonna come along. And it's no secret that I love how this bike rides. I'm gonna put this together as soon as possible so that I could take it out for a ride. Well, the left inner panel is on and the left side panel is on temporarily. I just got impatient. I just wanted to see what it looks like. I think it looks really good. I don't know what you guys think. And please, please, if you have any thoughts about it, put them in the comments down below to let us know what you think of this little play on gloss and satin finish that we did on this piece. It's one piece of carbon fiber, but we put that stealth PPF over it from Expel, so that half of it is satin and the other half, or it's not half, but other parts of it is gloss. I just wanna step back and take a look at it. This is on temporarily, guys, because I have a little more work to do underneath. I just want to see how it looks like, but this bike's gonna be a stunner when we're done with it. I'm pretty sure of that. So I have one more piece of carbon fiber that I wanna put on. I don't know if I wanna do gloss or satin yet, so I may just play around a little bit before I install it. Obviously in this video, you guys are gonna see what I chose. But this is looking really good. I'm getting even more and more worked up so that I can get this bike finished. It's not gonna happen in this episode. As I mentioned, we still have our other panels waiting to go on, and it's a Nicholas at Auto Laboratory so that he could finish it off for us with this stealth PPF as well. I'm not gonna say it, but you guys probably know which pieces those are. Until then, let me finish this and then we'll call this episode finished. Looks like I decided, and it's gonna be gloss. This is a super easy part to replace. You don't need half the motorcycle apart to remove this, and it fits like a glove. I actually like this rubber piece that's around it. That kind of makes it that finished look. Well, that's it for this episode of the Panigale V2 build, guys. And again, I'm asking you guys, what do you guys think? You guys think this is a good idea? You think it looks good? I know it's kind of hard to say without seeing the side panels, but I give you a little bit of a teaser. And up top over here, this is gonna look really good while I'm riding the bike, because if you guys haven't noticed, I really like to do things that it's in my peripheral or vision when I'm riding. Those are the things that you really get to see when you're riding the motorcycle. You don't get to see the motorcycle as a whole. You do when you're parked, when you're having your food, or when it's sitting in your garage. But when you're riding, this view I think is the most important view. And also when you're riding, if you want to get away from the elements, especially if you're on the track, the windscreen is very, very important to be able to tuck underneath it. So now we have our WRS windscreen as well. So I'm really, really excited on how this build is taking shape. And as you guys saw, we've changed some stuff along the way that when we're going, so we had an idea what we're gonna do, but we decided to completely scrap some of the ideas because we just fell in love with the shape and form the spike was taking. And that goes to show you, you can try to plan it as much as you want, but sometimes some ideas are better when they're visualized. And in this case, this gray, black, and carbon theme bike is gonna look really good. And I want to take this moment to ask you guys something. You guys have been watching this build and the numbers of the views show it, but a lot of you guys who are viewing this video are not subscribed to our channel. It would really help us out with the algorithm of YouTube. If you haven't subscribed yet, just hit that subscribe button below. It really means a lot to us. The more viewers we have, the more subscribers we have, the more drive we have to do builds like this and show them to you on camera. So if you guys can do that for me, I'd really appreciate it. But I think that's really it for this episode, guys. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, leave them down below. Until next time, guys, have a good one.